How you guys doing? Thank you for joining us here on SB 252. So Tennessee's long-awaited coaching vacancy has just been filled, and they did it by going after Alabama's defensive coordinator, Jeremy Pruitt. A very good defensive coordinator. Coached the team to a defensive championship last year, where they eventually lost, of course, but they still made it. Guys like Marlon Humphreys and Jonathan Allen went to the NFL just this past draft from his defense. So Tennessee finally filled that coaching vacancy with him. We'll see what happens.
And of course, this is in light of the Schiano fiasco just the other week. Well, actually, just last weekend, the team was trying to hire Greg Schiano. There was a whole bunch of protests. We all know about that. We made a video about that. We don't want to get into that again. But after that fiasco, it had a bad look on the college. So much so that they've gone through a whole list of coaches, including Oklahoma State's Mike Gundy, who turned down a six-year, $42 million contract to go there, which was more pay than what he's going to get paid at Oklahoma State. We had Jeff Brohm from Purdue turn him down. Dave Doran, North Carolina State, turn him down. We've had Duke's head coach turn him down. So many people have turned him down because they don't want to coach there. This program went 4-7 last year, but the real reason is the new instability, especially now that they fired their athletic director, John Curry. And although their new athletic director, Philip Fulmer, is a former coach of Tennessee and Hall of Fame college football head coach who won a national championship in 1998, maybe he'll help turn that program around, but it still turned people away because of the instability.
Definitely, for sure. I mean, you think about guys like that, and then we also think about the former coach who used to coach there, who was offensive coordinator for Alabama, Lane Kiffin. You know, he's come out and he's done tweets to mock this Tennessee team. You know, you just wouldn't expect that. And then after they fired their athletic director, John Curry, you would have thought that he might have possibly wanted to come back. On top of that, there were rumors that he still would come back. Well, he hasn't made any move to come back to Tennessee. So Tennessee, obviously, it looks bad. And this program is definitely going to hurt from the effects of this for some time. But I'm surprised that they actually found that this Alabama defensive coordinator, because that is a steal. That's definitely a steal. Now, you can say, oh, Nick Saban, he's just a product of him. We'll see about that. I think he's a good hire. The best that they can get. For sure.
But still, I think Tennessee may be losing some recruits in the future just because of their bad look. And this guy is a good defensive coordinator, as you were saying. He coached at Alabama. He's coached at Florida State when they won the national title. Coach at Georgia. But still, at the same time, I know if I were a high school student looking to go into Tennessee, even if I were a defensive player, I'll take a second look at him.
That is a really good point that you bring up about recruits. I wasn't even thinking about that because you can have the coach in line, but the look, no one's going to want to go to Tennessee anymore. Now, you might have a few guys who are from the area, but for the most part, recruits are going to overlook this program.
But what this coach is going to have to do is he's going to have to look at colleges like Penn State, who rebuilt their image, and it took several years.
Sure did.
And not as long as I actually thought it would take. Whenever that scandal happened, they've been very successful at rebuilding themselves. But this coach has a long way up. The odds are stacked against him. Not saying that this is a bad hiring, as you said. It was a pretty good hiring considering the situation, but it's still a long road to recovery within that fan base and within their image nationwide.
And to conclude, obviously, he's going to have to separate the old from the new. He's going to have to tell these recruits, hey, listen, I had nothing to do with that. Me and the new athletic director, that we had nothing to do with that. That was the past, and we're looking to move on to the future. So we'll see what happens with Tennessee. Finally, we were waiting for about a week and a half to tell you guys the news, and here we are. It just happened. Talk to you guys later. Appreciate you guys watching.